Hi everyone, my name is Aparna Pansare and this is my colleague here, Supriya. We are going to talk about a few of the projects which we are offering on the Open edX platform and the Sunbird platform. I'll tell you what both of these are, and they are mainly related to the theme of storage and cloud. So before I start the presentation, one question which I want to ask everyone, how many of you have GitHub accounts? Okay, I'm very encouraged to see that. How many do your own Ubuntu and related installations? Okay, good. How many have created a project and uploaded something in GitHub? Okay, cool. So, yes, so the reason I asked is because we use a lot of open source in our projects. In fact, we very firmly believe in the philosophy of open source. And it always helps to have people who have already done something in open source. So the learning curve is sort of less steep in that case. Okay, so the three projects which we are offering, the first one is implementation of a content repository for Open edX. So as I said that all our projects are around the theme of storage and cloud. Okay, so Open edX is one platform which we have hosted here at IIT Bombay. What we want to do is to enhance it and provide for another customization of a content repository on a specific storage type. The second project is implementation of content repository for the project Sunbird. So this is another open source project, Project Sunbird, which we are exploring right now. And the second project is around enhancing the content storage of that to use some storage solutions. And the third project is enhancing the Sunbird telemetry. Telemetry is an analytics engine, sort of, you can say, of the Sunbird project. So enhancing this to support the local storage. So as you can see, the common theme is around storage. So talk a little bit about Open edX. So Open edX is an open source learning management platform. Some of you may have done courses on Coursera and Udacity, Udemy, all of that. So edX is something similar. The difference is that Open edX, the open source version of it, is free for anybody to use it. So that has been adopted at IIT Bombay, and we have hosted our own platform after doing some customizations on that platform. So Open edX related activity is a continuing activity happening at IIT. So this was made open source in 2013. This is the GitHub repository for those who are interested, and these are few of the technologies used in that platform. So this is the architecture of Open edX. So you don't have to really look into what is written inside each of these small boxes. The only thing of interest is this certificates, reports, and another cloud that you can see the videos part of it. So these are some of the data stores that are used by the Open edX architecture. Other than databases, obviously the MySQL, Mongo database, many other types of data stores that you have. But there are some cloud-based content stores which are being used by the platform. So the first project is to enhance this platform so that we can use a stack such as, say, the Red Hat's storage solution, or let's say Amazon storage solution, some customized storage solution, enhancing it to support that. Okay, so that's the first project. So we replace whatever the Open edX platform is supporting, completely build a piece which you plug into the Open edX platform so that you can support the external storage. So that's the first project. So the scope of the project is, as I said, to enhance the Open edX platform to enable customized content store. Okay, so these are some of the sample data storage points that are there in the application. The technology that we are looking for, because the Open edX platform is based on these technologies, Python, Django, the REST framework, which is the microservices or service oriented kind of architecture that it uses, cloud, agile methodology is what we'll use for the implementation of this project, Git obviously, and storage domain. So storage, we are not expecting people to really know. In fact, we are not expecting people to know any of these technologies, but the more amongst these that you know, the better for you and better for us, because we don't have to teach you. Otherwise, we are happy to learn together with you on the job, because we are going to start a new initiative sort of on the storage domain. So we will also be learning as you learn. The complexity of this project is very high. So people who are interested in the storage domain, who like to get their hands dirty on the operating side of things, building, installing, all of that, I think this should excite you. The second project is Project Sunbird. This is another open source project like the Open edX platform. This is something similar. This is a more newer initiative. So again, we are ourselves exploring how this platform works. So this is what the architecture that we have figured out so far. So what it has is, other than the authentication and all of that, so there are these REST APIs, if anybody has heard about it, microservices. So the entire platform is built in such a way that there are components or services using which you can build your entire application. Okay, so if you want, you can enhance it by providing your own APIs or your own microservices, or you can build using their APIs, or you can customize their APIs. So this is what the architecture is built like. And behind that, if you see those two clouds which are of interest, so none of this is of much interest, attached the cloud picture in any diagram. So the X-step infra is where their content is being stored right now, and the IITB infra is where we would like to store that content. So again, a storage solution, a local storage solution that we will have at IIT Bombay supporting that. So building the entire storage, whatever middleware, which will store data onto that that platform. So these are some of the other things which are part of the application, not of interest to us. Of interest to us is that. So building the REST APIs to store data on the storage solution. That's what the project is all about. So technologies here again are something similar. Python, this has Java. The first one didn't have Java so much. This has Java. But I think all of you can easily pick up one language, because I would say that if you know one, if you're solid knowledge on one programming language, you can pick up any other. So we are not really expecting you to know Python or anything like that. I'm sure you will pick up. The third one is telemetry. That's the analytics sort of engine of the Sunbird platform. Actually, we know the least about this this piece of it. So analytics, some of you may know what it is. So it is basically deriving some information based on some user's actions. So based on how a student behaves while attending an online course, which are the parts which he finds more difficult, where he is pausing, what is he repeating, based on all of that, you conclude what is the sort of learning curve of the student, so that you can customize the content to meet his personalized requirement. That's what analytics should do in a learning context. So what this does is, it again provides some APIs through which you will either store the telemetry data or the analytics student behavior data onto a storage solution, or you will retrieve and then display it to the faculty so that he can see how well the student is learning. So that's what the telemetry is all about. So again, keeping in line with the storage theme, here we'll build a customized storage solution where the telemetry data will be stored, where it will be retrieved from. And to demonstrate that your solution is actually working, how will you, I mean, if you just build APIs and say that, okay, this is deployed, it is not going to make sense. You need to have a sample application which shows that your data is actually going into your storage solution, it is being retrieved. So building a sample application which demonstrates what you have built around the storage solution. That's what this project is all about. So again, similar technologies, again, complexity is high. What is common to these three projects, other than the storage theme, is that you will get to learn how to implement a complete life cycle of a project. Because we are in the exploratory stage in both of these projects, we are also learning together with you. So right from building the specification to making the final test cases and actually delivering it onto a production-like, obviously it will not go into production, but a production-like environment. So that entire life cycle you will get to learn. You will get exposure to the latest technologies such as storage, cloud, and all of that. You will be in a position to make a significant contribution and a demonstrable contribution. You all will have your GitHub accounts. You can upload your projects on your GitHub. You can show it as a proof of what you have delivered anytime. It's like something which you can show as a badge of honor that this is what I have actually delivered. And you will get a confidence to deliver a project. Fully functional system. It may not go into production, as I said, but it will be something which will work end to end. So that confidence is something which I find interns, when they come here, they are lacking because they have never delivered a project. But once they leave from here, they know that they can deliver, whether it's a small piece or a big piece, but end to end, they know it is something which can be used. So that's what I think you will gain from this. These are some references. So thank you, and we look forward to whoever makes the choice of these three projects, and look forward to learn together with you guys. Any questions? Okay, thank you.